Welcome back. Joining me now is former Congressman Charlie Rangel of New York. He has been a powerhouse until his retirement recently. Congressman, thank you very much for being here on this show. It's an honor.
Thank you, Jim, for inviting me.
It just seems the fortunes have you on the show on a time when there is so momentous news going on. What is your reaction to President Trump's comments with regard to Haiti and Africa in general?
I've been fortunate, Jim, that when I face terrible disappointments, that having almost died in Korea, I thank God for letting me know there's a problem going on and try to avoid the anger. And even though it's difficult to say anything kind about Trump, it seems to me it might be good for my great country. We forget so many things about why so many people have come here for hope and opportunities, and so many of them come here and they forget what it's all about. And we just can't afford the ignorance and the insults. But there is a contribution to make, because as Dr. Martin Luther King said, and I'm talking at the Church of Incarnation, I have to change my whole remarks, that it's not so much what terrible people do, it's when good people are silent about it. And I just hope that my Republican friends and people who have no political persuasion, especially our spiritual leaders, would say, America deserves better.
Are you surprised that you don't hear more outrage coming from Republicans? That Paul Ryan, we're taping this on Friday, Paul Ryan's comments today was that he was, you know, that Trump, Donald Trump's comments were not helpful. He didn't condemn them, he just said they weren't helpful. We've been waiting to hear from Mario Diaz-Balart, who Republican who was in the meeting. I know you know, sure. Congressman Diaz-Balart. We haven't really heard him condemn the remarks. Is it a problem when people want to try to side up alongside this president that they decide not to confront him?
Yes, it is a problem. The problem is that the Republican Party, they've had an agenda since Franklin Roosevelt, and that is to disband all of the social programs, Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, and also to reduce taxes. They truly believe the private sector and not the government should provide this helping hand. It's really remarkable that so many come from families of immigrants that had received that helping hand.
Well, you know Haiti fairly well. You've traveled to Haiti a number of times. What's your impression of Haiti?
My impression is that anybody that fought with us in the American Revolution was on our side. Mm-hmm. We should be thankful to them. But I was just telling the commissioner.
Commissioner Monestein, who was in earlier, right.
I was just telling him, why should Haitians and people of African countries apologize? Why shouldn't Americans realize where they came from? If you're not a Native American and you weren't brought over here in chains, you must have had somebody in your bloodline had dreams and hopes and aspirations. And when you come, why can't that compassion flow? I think the silence of the churches, not the Republicans, and saying that so many fled wherever they was just to be able to pray. And if we're talking about human beings, just because we have somebody in the White House that's unfit, a great republic like ours should take a step back? No.
Well, it's also redefining what America is. Rather than being a beacon of hope for others to pull themselves up, we now want to make it almost a zero-sum game as to what can you contribute to us as a society in terms of technological abilities or others before we evaluate whether you should come in, rather than growing and prospering with the people who do come here.
Jim, what you just said is that's what we do. I know your intent is that's what our country's about. It's not, most Americans believe in exactly what you said, and that is that what inspires America, that even if you're not doing well, you know, in this country, you can get there faster than any other country.
Martin Luther King Day is Monday. I know that's part of the reason why you're down here. I don't want to ask you what would Martin Luther King think about this, but talk to me about the spirit of Martin Luther King and how he should guide us, how that memory should guide us as we now deal with the issues we're confronting with Donald Trump.
Martin Luther King wanted to make this a greater country. He thought in America that if we could just look at each other and see past the color and see what contribution a person was going to make to society. He talked often about our children who were never born with hatred and prejudice. If they could see each other just as God's children, to contribute, to care, and to work together. This is the concept of America. America wasn't thinking about making slaves president. But the Constitution was so flexible. It believed in God, and God has led us to a higher standard. We can't let one person, a handful of other people, who because of their ignorance, take us back. We owe too much for where we are today, you, me, and most Americans, to allow this to happen. So I hope that this is the beginning of a new change. You said it yourself earlier, where America can say that I have been quiet too long. This is the time for silent people to show that they are indeed Americans. And Republicans who have their own agenda, you know, just sleeping with people like the president in order to cut taxes and dismantle programs, now they're saying if you're on Medicaid, you ought to get yourself a job. I don't know how that works.
Congressman Rangel, I want to truly thank you for coming in. I know you're here for a number of events, including with Congresswoman Frederica Wilson.
So yeah, that's Monday
again,
morning.
Monday morning. So again, thank you very much for your time. We'll be right back after the break.